Now let's see about paging. Paging is an example for non-contiguous memory allocation. Non-contiguous memory allocation means wherever there is a free space, then operating system can allocate that free space for the corresponding process. That means the memory locations need not be in contiguous allocations, contiguous locations. Okay. We have a process whose size is 5 MB. Let this is our main memory. Let we have 1 MB of free space is there. Let we have 3 MB of free space is here. Let we have 1 MB of free space here. All these spaces are occupied. So let us assume that main memory contains three partitions like this. So 1 MB of this partition, next to 3 MB partition, next to 1 MB partition. So what is the size of our process? Let name of the process is P1, whose size is 5 MB. Then operating system can use these three partitions in order to store the process P1. So the first 1 MB of P1 will be stored here, next to 3 MB will be stored here, next to 1 MB will be stored here. So this is nothing but non-contiguous memory allocation. So wherever there is a free space, then operating system can make use of that free space for storing the process. So let's see how paging will be implemented. In paging, the process is divided into a number of partitions called pages. The size of each page must be same. That means if page 0 size is 1 KB, then the remaining pages size is also 1 KB. So page 1 size is also 1 KB, page 2 is also 1 KB, page 3 size is also 1 KB. Next, this is nothing but our main memory. Main memory is also divided into a number of partitions called frames. Here the size of each frame must be same. That means if first frame size is 1 KB, then the second frame size is also 1 KB, third frame size is also 1 KB, like that. Okay. And one more point here is the page size and frame size must be equal. Page size and frame size must be equal. So here we have 3 points. First point, this is process. Process means logical memory. This is main memory. Main memory is nothing but physical memory. A process is divided into a number of partitions called pages, and the size of each page must be same only. Second point, main memory is divided into a number of partitions called frames, and the size of each frame must be same. If frame 1 size is 1 KB, then frame 2 size is also 1 KB, frame 3 size is also 1 KB, like that. Next point, page size and frame size must be same. Next, whenever CPU needs to execute a process, then the pages of the process from the secondary memory are loaded into frames of the main memory. So this is our process. So we know that the process is divided into a number of equal size partitions called pages. So this is our process. Let our process contains 4 pages, where the first page is page 0, second page page 1, second third page page 2, fourth page page 3, like that. So this is our main memory. So the main memory is divided into a number of equal size partitions called frames. Okay, this frame size and page size should be same. Next, this is nothing but page table. Page table accepts page number as the input and it produces frame number as the output. So here the first row specifies that page number 0 is available in frame number 1. So these are nothing but frame numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. These are nothing but frame numbers. So page number 0 is available in frame number 1. So this frame number 1 contains page 0. Next, the second line specifies that page 1 is available in frame 4. So fourth frame contains page 1. This line specifies that page 2 is available in frame 3. So frame 3 contains page 2. So this line specifies that Page 3 is available in frame 7. So frame 7 contains page 3. Now let's see paging hardware. Paging hardware, in order to execute any instruction, CPU generates logical address for the corresponding instruction. Logical address is mainly divided into two parts. The first part specifies page number. The second part specifies D, means page offset. So what is the first part? Page number. Second part, page offset. Here D stands for displacement. So page offset is nothing but displacement. So let we have a page like this. Let this page contains 100 locations. So this is nothing but displacement. So which instruction we are accessing? Let we are accessing the first instruction of the page. So displacement or offset is 0. Let we want to access first instruction. Then the displacement or offset is 1. Let we want to access 10th instruction. Then displacement or offset is 9. So like that. So see, in order to execute any instruction, CPU generates logical address. Here the logical address is divided into two parts. The first part specifies page number. Page number is denoted with P. The second part specifies page offset. Page offset means displacement. Displacement means line number within the page, location within the page. So let we have 100 elements, let we have 100 instructions in the page. So in order to access the first instruction, here the offset is 1. So if you want to access the second instruction, then offset is 2. If you want to access 10th instruction, then offset is 10, like that. Okay, this page number will be given as input to the page table. Page table accepts page number as the input and it produces frame number as the output. So this is page table. So page table is accepting page number as the input and it is producing frame number as the output. Here F stands for frame number. If we combine frame number with this offset, if we combine frame number with the offset, then it will give the exact physical address in the main memory, so that CPU executes the corresponding instruction which is available at this address. So here we have two addresses, logical address, physical address. Logical address means the address generated by the CPU, whereas physical address means the address generated by the main memory. So this is about paging hardware. Now let's see this example. Paging example for a 32 byte memory with 4 byte pages. So the size of the main memory is 32 bytes, and the size of a process, the size of a page is 4 bytes. So this is our process or logical memory. So we know that the process is divided into a number of partitions called pages. Here the size of a page is 4 bytes. So the size of a frame will also becomes 4 bytes. Why? Because we have to load the page into the frame. Okay. So the size of the main memory is 32 bytes. So main memory is also divided into a number of partitions called frames, where the size of a frame is what? 4 bytes. So 4 into totally we have 8 frames here. So this is 0th frame, 1st frame, 2nd frame, 3rd frame, 4th frame, 5th frame, this is 6th frame, and this is nothing but 7th frame. So this page map table specifies the page number and the corresponding frame number output. So here it specifies that page number 0 is stored in frame number 5. So this is frame number 5. So what is page 0? This is page 0. So what is the content of page 0? A, B, C, D. So first location instruction A, second offset instruction B, next offset C, like that. Okay. So in which page, in which frame we have page 0? In 5th frame. So this is 5th frame. So in 20 we have to store A, in 21 B, in 22 C, next D. Okay. Here if you want, we can calculate the physical address with the help of a formula. Here if you take the first instruction, if you take the first logical address, that is 0. Here the logical address is 0. So what is 0 here? 0 means this is 0th pace. So pace 0. So what is the offset here? This is nothing but 0th offset. So offset is also 0. So here the formula is very very simple. We have to check in which frame the corresponding pace is available. So this is pace 0. So pace 0 is available in frame 5. So 5 into. So what is the size of a pace? The size of a pace is 4 bytes. So 5 into 4 plus. What is the offset here? 0. So 5 into 4, 20. So 20 plus 0, 20. So in 20 we have A. If you take the next instruction, that is 1. Logical address 1. Okay. So what is logical address 1? This is nothing but pace 0 only. But what is the offset here? Here the offset is 1. 0 means offset 0. 1 means offset 1. Okay. So we know that pace 0 is stored in 5. So 5 into what is the size of your pace? 4 bytes plus what is the offset here? 1. So 5 into 4, 20. 20 plus 1, 21. So in 21 physical address, we have to store B here. Okay. So likewise, C and D will also be stored. Let us take the next one. So if you take the next byte, that is 4. So what is 4 here? 4 means it is pace 0. And what is the offset here? Offset is 0. So if you want to calculate the physical address, then what is the formula? Here 4 is nothing but page number 1. Page number 1 is available in frame number 6. So 6 into size of your page 4 bytes plus what is the offset here? 0. So 6 into 4, 24. So 24 plus 0, 24. So in 24 we have to store E. In 25 we have to store 5. In 26 address we have to store G. In 27 address we have to store 8. So likewise we have to calculate physical address for the corresponding logical address. Next, if you take page number 2, page number 2 is available in frame number 1. So this is frame number 1. So I, J, K, L. Next, this is nothing but page number 3. So page number 3 is available in frame number 2. Page number 3 is available in frame number 2. So this is frame number 2. So in frame number 2, we have to store MNOP. MNOP. So here, what is P here? P means, let us calculate the physical address for this 15. So what is 15 here? 15 means page number, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. So page number 3, what is the offset here? 0, 1, 2, 3. Offset is also 3 here. Okay. So this is start page. Start page is available in frame number 2. So 2 into, what is the size of a page? 4 bytes. So 2 into 4 plus, what is the offset here? 3. So 2 into 4, 8. 8 plus 3 means 11. So in 11 physical address we have to store P. So this is nothing but 11. So in 11 we have to store P. So in this way we can find out the physical address for the corresponding logical address. Now let's see about implementation of pace table. So where we have to store pace table? If we store pace table inside a register, generally we know that registers are very very faster than main memory, but registers are very very smaller as well as very very expensive. If you store pace table inside a register, then we can access the data in a faster manner. But here the problem is the size of a register is very very small. Generally register size will be like 1 KB, 2 KB, 3 KB, like that. Whereas pace table contains lakhs of entries, lakhs of pages. So it is not possible to store a large pace table inside a register. So that's why we need to store pace table inside a main memory. If we store pace table inside a main memory, then the problem is we require two memory accesses. We require two memory accesses for accessing an instruction, for executing an instruction. One memory access for accessing the page table, another memory access for accessing the main memory. We know that CPU generates logical address. Logical address is divided into two parts: page number offset, page number will be given as input to the page table. So in order to access the page table, we require one memory access. Next, if you combine frame number with page table, produces frame number as the output. If you combine frame number with offset, it will give the physical address. So in order to access the physical address, we require two second memory access. So we need to have two memory accesses for executing a single instruction. So if we have lakhs of instructions, then we need to have lakhs of memory accesses. Okay, so that is the problem here. For executing a single instruction, instead of one memory access, we need to have two memory accesses. So this is the problem here. So in order to overcome this problem, we use a faster, smaller catch called translation look aside buffer. In short, we can call it as TLB. TLB is a smaller, faster, special catch. Here catch means it is not a cache memory, okay, it is a register only, but it stores large amount of data. Okay, next, TLB is associative memory. We know that as in associative memory, information is stored in the form of tags, where each tag is represented in the form of a pair. The first component of the pair is key, the second component of the pair is value. Here key means page number, value means frame number. So let's see the diagram here. Paging hardware with translation look aside buffer. Now translation look, this is TLB. TLB mainly contains the most frequently accessed entries of the page table. Let page table contains 1000 pages. Out of those 1000 pages, let we are accessing 10 pages very frequently. So TLB contains those 10 pages. Okay, the most frequently accessed pages. So out of 100 pages, let us assume that we want to access 5 pages very frequently. So those 5 pages will be stored in the TLB. Okay, so first, CPU generates a logical address. That logical address is divided into two parts, page number, offset. This page number will be compared with all the page numbers. Okay, here this is TLB. So in TLB, what will happen is every page number will be compared with this page number. So if there is any match found, then it will give the corresponding frame number. Okay, so what we are doing, we are giving page number as the input to the TLB. So in TLB, what will happen, this page number will be compared with all the page numbers. If there is a match found, then it is called as TLB hit. So hit specifies that the corresponding page number is available in TLB. So TLB has two entries, two columns, page number, frame number. It gives frame number as the output. If we combine frame number with this offset, it will give the physical address. So we can access that instruction in a faster manner. Here also, for accessing the instruction, we need to have one memory access. But here this TLB is very, very faster than if page table resides in main memory. Okay, so that that instruction will be accessed in a faster manner. Next, if page number is not available in TLB, then this page number will be given as input to the page table. This page table resides in main memory only. Okay, so page table, this is called as TLB miss. So TLB miss means the corresponding page is not available in TLB. Okay, so page table accepts page number as the input and produces frame number as the output. If we combine frame number with offset, then it will give the physical address so that CPU access that instruction. Here, after getting the frame number, the corresponding entry, that means that page number and frame number information, will be updated in TLB. Suppose if TLB is full, then one of the row will be replaced with this new row. This new row contains what? Page number and column, page number and frame number. Okay, that for replacement we have several replacement algorithms. Okay, So in this way we can implement TLB. Now let's see how to provide protection in paging. So this is our process, this is page table and this is main memory. So this process is divided into four pages and this is page table. So page table accepts page number as the input and produces frame number as the output. So the first row specifies that page number 0 is available in frame number 2. So in frame 2 we have page 0. Here the protection bit is operating system provide the protection bit with the help of VRI, where V stands for valid bit, whereas I stands for invalid bit. Or in place of V we can use 1, in place of invalid we can use 0. So valid or 1 specifies that the corresponding page is belonging to the process, whereas this invalid specifies that the corresponding page number doesn't belong to the process. So here page number 0 is belonging to the process. So here the protection bit is V. Next, the second row specifies that page number 1 is available in frame number 3. So in frame 3 we have page 1. So this V specifies that this page 1 belonging to the process. Next, this row specifies that page 2 is available in frame 4. So in frame 4 we have page 2. So V specifies that this page number 2 is belonging to this process. Next, this V specifies that this page number 3 is belonging to the process. If you take 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6 are no longer belonging to the process. So here the protection bit is I. So I stands for invalid bit. So these processes doesn't belong to the process. So while creating the page table, if the corresponding process is belonging to the process, then protection bit means VR, it is set to 1. Okay. So if CPU needs to access fourth page, then automatically here we have a invalid bit. So what will happen? CPU doesn't access this page, even though some frame number is available here, even though some frame is specified. Let us assume that some statements are like this. It specifies that page 4 is available in frame 0. But here, what is the protection bit here? I means invalid bit. Invalid means this page 4 doesn't belong to the process. So CPU doesn't execute this process. Likewise, CPU doesn't execute this page number. Likewise, CPU doesn't execute this page. Why? Because these three protection bits are I. So in this way, we can provide protection mechanism for the paging environment with the help of a protection bit, VRI. So V means protection is set. That means that page number is belonging to the process. I means it is 0. That means there is no protection. That means this page doesn't belong to the process. One of the advantages of paging is shared pages. In a multi-programming, multiple users can execute multiple processes by sitting at different computers. Let us assume that there are three persons who are working on the same application called text editor. So let us assume that three persons wants to make use of text editor. So instead of using text editor at three computers, what we can do is we can share this text editor page. So this is nothing but shared pages. Here each process has its own data and its own registers, but all the processes needs to use text editor. Let this editor is read-only code. Read-only means only we can read the data from the application. It is not possible to make any modifications on the text editor. So here the text editor is an application which is shared by three processes, and each process has its own data. Let's take this example. So this is process P1. This is page table for P1 process. This is process P2. This is page table for P2. This is process P3 and this diagram is for page table for P3. Here let us assume that in text editor we have two pages. So ED1, ED2. ED1, ED2. So these two pages are belonging to the text editor. So we have to use these two pages in all the three processes. Okay. So what is the page table here? We know that page table accepts page number as the input and it produces frame number as the output. So here page 0 means ED1. ED1 is available in frame 3. So in frame 3 we have ED1. Next, page number 1 is available in frame number 4. So in frame number 4 we have ED2. Next, data 1. So this data 1 is nothing but P1 own data, P1 own application. So here what is the frame number for page number 2? Frame number 1. So in frame number 1 we have page 2. So what is page 2? Data 1. Okay. Next, if we consider the second process. So in this process also we are using text editor application ED1, ED2. So 0th page is available in page number 3. So there is no need to store one more time. So already we have that page number and corresponding frame data. Next, page number 1 means frame number 4. So already 4 contains ED2. Next, this data 2 is nothing but process P2 own application. Process P2 own page. Okay. So we have to store in separate frame called 2. So already we have assigned 2. So let us assign 1 here. So here page number 2 is available in frame number 1. So this is frame number 1. So in frame number 1 store data 2. Next, if you consider the third application. So in page 0 and page 1 we have page number 0 is available in frame number 3. So 3-4 means ED1, ED2. Next, page number 2 means data 3. Data 3 is available in what? Frame number 5. So in 5 we have data 3. Okay. So instead of using text editor in each computer, in each process, what we are doing? We are sharing that text editor so that only one copy will be used. So the amount of memory will be saved now. Okay. So this is the advantage of shared pages. So this is about paging concept.